We now take the next topic as trigonometrical identities. So we try to prove first the three identities. Let us consider ABC is a right angle triangle with C as theta. Now we have to prove the first identity. So we now apply by Pythagoras theorem. We know AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. We now divide the whole equation by AC square. We get AC square upon AC square is equal to AB upon AC square, AC the whole square plus BC upon AC the whole square. This is also whole square. Now this is 1 is equal to AB upon AC. AB upon AC is sine of sine square theta plus BC upon AC is cos theta, therefore this is cos square theta. So we have this, the first identity. Sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Now to prove second identity, we now divide this whole equation by AB square. We get AC upon AB the whole square is equal to AB upon AB the whole square plus BC upon AB the whole square. AC upon AB. AC upon AB is cosec square theta is equal to 1 plus BC upon AB. BC upon AB is cot square theta. So we have the identity as cosec square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. This is the second identity. Now we try to prove this third one. We now divide this equation by BC square. We get AC upon BC the whole square is equal to AB upon BC the whole square plus BC square, BC upon BC the whole square. Now AC upon BC. AC upon BC is sec square theta is equal to AB upon BC is tan square theta plus 1. And so the third identity is sec square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. So as such, we have proved the three identities. The first is sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Second is sec square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. Third is cosec square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. So we have the three identities, and we try to solve now a few problems regarding these identities. The first question is, question first. Prove that tan square theta minus 1 upon cos square theta plus 1 is equal to 0. So the answer is, taking left hand side is equal to this one. So this is tan square theta. 1 upon cos square theta means sec square theta plus 1 is equal to, you take minus sign out, this becomes sec square theta minus tan square theta plus 1 is equal to minus, when we put the identity as 1, this is minus 1 plus 1 is equal to 0, hence is equal to RHS. So we have proved this is equal to this. Now the second question. Second question is, prove that 10 to the power 4 theta minus 10 square theta is equal to sec power 4 theta minus sec square theta. You take left hand side. 10 4 theta minus 10 square theta. 10 square theta is common. So this is 10 square theta minus 1 is equal to 10 square theta. Sorry, you directly put down the value here. Sec square, 10 square theta can be written as sec square theta minus 1. And here this is sec square theta. We use the identity. Now multiply the sec to the power 4 theta minus sec square theta is equal to RHS. Hence the result. We prove the third question. The third one is, prove that square root of sec square theta plus cosec square theta is equal to tan theta plus cot theta. Again we take that inside. So left hand side is under root sec square theta plus cosec square theta is equal to. We use identities. Sec square theta is equal to 1 plus tan square theta. And cosec square theta is equal to 1 plus cot square theta. As such, we have tan square theta plus cot square theta and plus 2. Now we manipulate 2 dot tan theta dot cot theta. We write this. We write 2 dot this. Now cot theta is equal to 1 upon tan theta, so we both will cancel. We have the same result as 2. Is equal to tan theta plus cot theta the whole square is equal to tan theta plus cot theta is equal to RHS. Hence the result. We now prove the third one. Next one. Next is prove that sin theta upon 1 plus cos theta is equal to cosec theta minus cot theta. So we take left hand side. Left hand side is equal to sin theta upon 1 plus cos theta. So we rationalize here. The denominator by 1 minus cos theta is equal to sin theta into 1 minus cos theta whole upon 1 minus a plus b, a minus b is a square minus b square, so it becomes 1 minus cos square theta is equal to sin theta 1 minus cos theta whole upon sin square theta. We use identities. 1 minus cos square theta is equal to sin square theta. So sin and sin cancel. This is equal to 1 minus cos theta upon sin theta. Now we distribute 1 upon sin theta minus cos theta upon sin theta. So this becomes cosec theta minus cot theta is equal to RHS. Hence proved. We now take another question. Prove that under root 1 minus cos theta upon 1 plus cos theta is equal to cosec theta minus cot theta. RHS. 1 minus cos theta, 1 plus cos theta. Now we rationalize rho vector again. 1 minus cos theta upon 1 minus cos theta is equal to multiply this and this whole square. This is 1 minus cos square theta is equal to under root 1 minus cos theta whole upon sin square theta. Now this becomes 1 minus cos theta upon sin theta. Square root is gone. Now we distribute this. 1 upon sin theta minus cos theta upon sin theta. So this is equal to cosec theta minus cot theta is equal to RHS. Hence the result. As such, we have the result. Now we have the final question. Prove that tan theta plus sec theta minus 1 whole upon tan theta minus sec theta plus 1 is equal to 1 plus sin theta upon cos theta. Now we take the left hand side. LHS. We replace 1 y its identity. So tan theta plus sec theta minus sec square theta minus tan square theta whole upon tan theta minus sec theta plus 1 is equal to, we factorize this. Minus sec theta plus tan theta and sec theta minus tan theta whole divided by tan theta minus sec theta plus 1 is equal to, this and this is common to both, so tan theta plus sec theta is common. What remains is 1 minus sec theta sign changes plus tan theta upon tan theta minus sec theta plus 1 is equal to, now this and this cancel, what remains, tan theta plus sec theta which changes into sin and cos, sin theta upon cos theta plus 1 upon cos theta is equal to 1 plus sin theta upon cos theta is equal to RHS. Hence the result. So as such, we have been able to prove all the 6 identities. So this is enough for this section. Next time we will take more questions. Thank you.